Well, as for the hosts, as the two sides take to the field, Mick McCarthy, of course, in charge of them, City's former boss. They're without their talisman in midfield, Jerry Yates, which isn't a bad thing as far as City are concerned. And they've gone quite attacking, it must be said, in terms of their lineup and formation today. So in goal, Welshman, Denbighshire-born Chris Maxwell. A back four of Jordan Gabriel, former Bluebird Curtis Nelson, James Husband and Dom Thompson. In the middle, Callum Connolly, the captain, Sonny Carey and Charlie Patino. Up front, Josh Bowler, Morgan Rogers, former Man City man Ian Poveda. City lineup as follows then. Ryan Allsop in goal. Marlon Romeo into the side at right wing back, with a back three of Mark McGuinness, Cedric Kiepre and Perry and G. Rolls at left wing back. A deep lie in two of Wintle and Sawyers, who returns to the side in place of Andy Rinomota, with Philogene moving from right wing back into the number 10 slot. Connor Wickham starts alongside Sorry Cabot. On the bench for City then, Jack Anik is joined by Shea Ojo, Jack Simpson, Reuben Colwell, Mark Harris, Andy Rinomota and Isaac Davis. So three changes for City from the side that lost the South Wales derby, has started that game. O'Dowda missing out, of course. Rinomota and Ojo dropped to the bench. Wickham, Sawyers and Romeo come into the starting lineup. That's where it's quite stagnant. And G with a decent looking cross from the right. Go clear on his first keeper. Did well to stop the counter there because he was a little bit off balance. And G, ball forward towards Cabot. Flick on what he was looking for. Blackpool struggling to clear their line.
Brilliant
from Rawls. Effort at goal, dipping from Wickham from distance, but that's a goal kick.
Point to prove today, Conor Wickham. Need a big performance from him, and he's starting to see with that effort, he's trying to try something special. Not against it. We need to get shots on goal and pepper him.
Good tackle in the end from Wintle, and good work from Wickham to make that his. He's got Rawls outside him. Here is Joe Rawls. Now Philogene to his left, level with the edge of the box. Taking on Gabriel. At his crossing, now he creates a bit of space, driven across towards
Rawls. He's got to score, Mark. It should be 1-0. It's Conor Wickham, he's straight in front of goal, 7-8 yards out, and he's put it wide. It's a huge chance, and he should score.
Yeah, best chance of the game so far. Conor Wickham just couldn't steer it inside the post. Good work from him initially in Rawls and Philogene indeed.
I think he could have done with a bit of a break, really, rather than going away, all that travelling, and then playing for his country. Scored for his country, of course. But to then come back into this April for such a key player, we could have definitely done with him having a bit of a rest.
Here's Wickham. Oh, that's a nice ball into Cabba. He, in turn, lovely footwork to release Romeo, level with the edge of the box.
That's the ball.
It's not a bad ball. Wickham underneath!
Yes! And it's that man, Conor Wickham! Making up for what has been a very tough week for him. Oh, that's going to go a long way with the City fans. Cardiff City, one up at Blackpool.
As Sam said it, that's the ball. It was the ball. It was deep. It was hanging. It was begging for a 6'4" former Premier League striker to be on the end of it. And that's indeed who was. Conor Wickham with his first Bluebirds goal. City lead at Bluefield Road.
That ball from Marlon Romeo. Every giant forward would love that ball into the box. And Conor Wickham is the man to get on the end of it. It's a brilliant header, Mark. It really is.
Any such issues with the weather as Rawls takes a deep free kick looking for Kiepre, wins it in the air, headed away by Gabriel and as far as Romeo. To Sawyers, recycles possession. Wintle lifts it in, decent looking ball again. McGuinness up for it, doesn't fall kindly to Wickham. City have possession back with Kiepre. Oh, what an effort! Maxwell saves it, comes to Cabot on the far side in the area. He strikes, hits a Blackpool player. Kipre again on the volley, almost found Romeo. It'll be a corner. All Cardiff.
The away end are enjoying this, Mark, and so am I. Cedric Kipre, I mean, what do we see here? He's really plucked up with an absolute stunner there. Maxwell with a fine save.
Balls to take this corner. Wolves left-footed delivery. It's a good end. Oh, and Cabo almost got to it. Romeo will put it back in. He scuffed that a little. And Blackpool should clear their lines here. Only as far as Wintle. Heads high. Keep right. Forward into Philogene. Did really well. Here comes Joe Rawlson. Right wing back now. Got Philogene ahead of him. Rawls comes inside on his left foot. Cabot to Philogene. Oh. Into the area. Still going Philogene. Oh, it's a deflection corner. City on fire here.
They are, Mark. But we've got to get our second goal now, please. We've been on fire at Rotherham. I remember battering Blackpool at Cardiff City Stadium early this season and then drawing a 1-0. We need this second goal and I want it to come really, really soon.
Blackpool have a player down, which will kill momentum a little. Back on his feet now, though, is the forward, Charlie Patino. Corner this time from the Bluebirds left. Delivery comes in, almost dipped in under Charlie Maxwell's bar. Got a pull on it, though, in the end. Throw in this near side. Romeo to take the throw. Romeo.
Got some more good news. Birmingham have equalised against Reading.
That is good news. Wickham to Philogene, edge of the edge, a free kick.
Perry and G territory, come on.
It's just on the edge of the D. And guess who's got the ball in his hands?
It was in the, I'm not tempted too much fate, but it was in this grey kit that he did it at Birmingham.
It was. Two goals this season, one at Borough, one at Birmingham.
Both stunners.
33 minutes on the clock. And G steps up. Hits the wall, comes out to Romeo. He scuffed that wide. Bit of a letdown in the end. Probably the worst free kick he's taken after the build-up gave him.
You want to get the ball forward. And he's got Sorry Carver and ahead of him. And Jane and Philogene behind him doing all the nice technical stuff on the ball.
Ayatollah from Sabri Lamucci as Connor Wickham comes away down the left into the area here. Strike! Oh, what a save, Maxwell! I couldn't see who struck it because it was
Jane and Philogene, and he has absolutely put his laces through that. I'm not sure how Chris Maxwell saved this.
Two good saves from Chris Maxwell so far. And it's fun in the sun here for City fans. Headed infield, Wintle again releases Wickham down that left-hand side where City are rampant. Ball. Lovely ball in towards Cabba, and it was round the keeper! 2-0!
It's Sorry Cabba again! This is a brilliant away day for the Bluebirds. You can hear them next to us. Everyone is having fun at Bluefield Road as we go 2-up on 37 minutes. Beautiful ball from Connor Wickham over the top. Sorry, Carver. Takes it on, takes it around the keeper and puts us 2-up.
It was not dissimilar to Ryan Giles' delivery for Kiefer Moore last season. It was just floated left foot, just on a sixpence. Cabba brought it down, rounded the keeper and put it in the back of the net. Cardiff City lead by 2-0 at Bloomfield Road.
I'm enjoying my away day, Mark.
Well,
there we go.
If ever there's just watch this attack here as NG plays it into Wickham in the area. A cross goal! And here's Rawls!
Yeah!
Oh, Joe Rawls has made it three!
Oh, my word, Mark, this is beautiful! A captain's goal by my favourite man in the squad.
It was with his right foot. It was again brilliant from Wickham. A cross goal nobody could clear. Joe Rawls slots home with his right foot. Blackpool 0, Cardiff 3.
Oh, Mark, this is it. Maybe up there with my favourite away days, and I'm not sure how it could ever be beaten. This is beautiful. Joe Rawls on the score sheet. We are 3 up. I'm sorry to any Blackpool people around me. I'm not sure this is going to get any better. This is beautiful. I am loving this.
I want to stay now.
You're more than welcome to, mate. Give Joe Rawls his dues. He's been absolutely outstanding today. Playing on that left side, getting us going forward.
City haven't provided that attacking threat thus far in this second half, but I'd imagine the game plan would have been to keep things tight for the first 15 and see what happens.
Yeah, so thus far, more of the home side though. Three goal famous last words here.
It's popped into the area. Blackpool Cam opportunity cleared by McGuinness. Sawyer's ran into a bit of trouble, but City do clear their lines. There it is, actually. Romain Sawyer for Andy Winnemotta. Free kick taken short. Into the area. Oh, it's wide. It should have been a goal back for Blackpool there. Curtis Nelson it was. Heads wide. City turned off from that free kick. And there's still plenty of time for calamity, let me tell you. City can't turn off.
No, they can't. And any goal back just gives this home support the impetus. Got to be switched on. Got to be ready for every opportunity. And we weren't then.
Colwell is coming on. He's replacing Connor Wickham.
Well, he's going to get a big cheer, Connor Wickham. And deservedly so. He has been outstanding today. He had a point to prove, and he proved it. Fair play to the lad. You've got to step up when things like this happen. And I think he stepped up kindly. A goal and 2 assists.
On board forward, dealt with by Kidray. Comes back to Keshi Anderson, but City expertly play it away. Cabell, oh, back into Colwell. Good football down that right-hand side. Colwell keeps the ball in and holds on to it and wins a free kick. Really good. Free kick. Decent position, this. And G to take it. It's just near enough on the touchline, that far side. Not too far off the edge of the area. He delivers. Whipped ball in. No! Oh, and Cabba should have scored. He took his eyes off the ball at the last second.
He had a similar one last Saturday, Cabba.
Blackpool throw. And they go back to James Husband. Furthest man back for them. Tom Thompson, long ball forward towards CJ Hamilton. Hooked out of play by Perry and G for a Blackpool throw. It's good play. Hamilton into the area. Opportunity for Blackpool. Allsop is in the back of the net. Blackpool have one back. Allsop saved it with his foot, passed it straight into the path of Gabriel, I think it was. He couldn't really miss.
Bit nervy now, Mark.
Blackpool do look more threatening going forward. City are defending well, and Colwell drives out of defence. Wintle, left footed ball. Cabba's in behind you, is he? Went to ground. For a moment it looked like he may have been in. Now come Blackpool down the right. Keshi Anderson. Left footed. Oh, and McGuinness with a good block. It comes back to Anderson. And Wintle with a block this time. Philogy hooks the ball, but it comes back to Gabriel by this corner flag. Opportunity, bowler into the area. City can't clear their lines. Now Connolly strikes at Colwell. Still City don't clear. And G, now they do. Cabba slips at the critical moment. It'll come back Blackpool's way on halfway. Oh, yeah. All sucked down to Gabba at his near post.
Take your time, Rocky. This got far too nervy all of a sudden, Mark.
Yeah, it does, isn't it? It's the introduction of Hamilton and Anderson, two of the veterans of this Blackpool squad. Yeah, Cabot has done his job as well. Philogene is also
Sparky grinder.
Being replaced by Mark Harris. He's limping off the pitch, Philogene. 5 minutes left. Blackpool 1, Cardiff City 3. Good work, Wintle. Rinomata putting pressure on Anderson. It comes back to Husband, though. Bit of space is opened up. Oh, Allsop got two hands behind it.
It's a nice strike. I think it's from Connolly, the captain. Allsop's got two hands behind it to palm it away, but back into the danger area.
Free kick to Blackpool. Just in from the touchline, about 30 yards out on this right hand side. Corey with the delivery, and it's headed wide by Connolly. Couldn't get his angles right. He got to it first, though. Nelson. City compact, sitting in. Davis up top on his own, with Harris and Colwell just behind him. Decent enough ball through. Allsop came and wasn't convincing. It'll be a corner to Blackpool in the 90th minute. 4 minutes of stoppage time to be played. It's dealt with by Rinomata. Harris pushes out on Bowler. It comes back Corey's way, though. It's lifted in and it's well headed away. Free kick to City. A foul on McGuinness, I think.
Foul on McGuinness, or Rowles. Both of them threw their heads in there. Gave it their everything that they've done all game. Come on!
Final whistle at Bloomfield Road. What a critical result this could be in the course of the season. Cardiff City have seen off Blackpool by 3-1 here this afternoon. It was 3-0 at half-time to the Bluebirds. And in the second half, they laboured at times, but were always in control. And Mick McCarthy's side, not only have they lost today, but they are firmly staring down the barrel of the gun. One place off the foot of the table. Cardiff City have moved away from danger. Huddersfield won, but Reading and QPR have dropped points, and City, as since San, move up to 19th with a little bit of a gap now from those below them. It's been, as Sam said earlier, a good Friday here for the Bluebirds. On the coast in Blackpool, there's more work to be done at home to Sunderland on Monday. Kids for a quid, that one. If you can be there, please come along and make some of this noise that you can hear away to my left from our away supporters. We need a crowd there on Monday, and we need you to help the Bluebirds in their quest for safety. It's finished here. Very, very good news for Sabri Lamouchi and his side. Blackpool 1, Cardiff City 3.